Welcome back, friends. In this session, we are going to learn about nested for loop. You know already concept of loop, right? Concept of for loop, how the for loop is work. I don't have to explain everything here. Now I am going to explore how this nested for loop working. I am going to explain how this nested for loop is working. When you say nested for loop, you can see another for loop inside a for loop. You can see another for loop inside a main for loop. In our case, this is our main for loop. This is our main for loop. That is, this is the outer for loop. In this for loop, I have written another for loop here. Okay. This is the piece of code in my outer for loop will execute until this condition satisfied. Okay. Now we are going to check the execution process of this nested for loop. Okay. Very first time I value is 0, right? Very first time I value is 0. Let me put I value equal to 0. Very first time I value is 0. Then it will come to inside a outer for loop. Inside outer for loop, I am printing I equal to I value. What is I value? I equal to 0 will print. That's what I am saying here. I equal to I 0 will print. After printing I value, there is another program. There is another for loop I have written here. That in that program I am saying int j equal to 0, j lesser than 3, j plus plus. Very first time j value is 0. Then I am checking j is lesser than 3 or not. Since j is having a 0, 0 is lesser than 3. Condition is satisfied. It will come to inside a inner for loop block. It will print j equal to j value. What is the j current value here? J current value equal to 0. After printing j current value is 0, it will go to update section of inner for loop. That is here. It will go to update section of inner for loop. It will increase 1. J plus plus meaning it will increase 1 value for j. That meaning it will become a 1. J will become 1. Then it will come to the condition section. It will check j is lesser than 3 or not. Currently j value is 1, right? Yes, definitely j is lesser than 3. So condition is satisfied. It will come to inner for loop block and print this j value. What is the current j value now? J equal to 1. Then after printing j equal to 1, it will go to update section of our inner for loop. It will increase 1 value of j plus plus. That meaning j value will become 2, right? After changing the j value 2, it will come to the condition section. It will check j is lesser than 3 or not. Currently j value is 2, right? Yes, definitely 2 lesser than 3 only. Condition is satisfied. Again it will come here, print the j current value. So j value equal to 2 will print. After printing j value, again it will go to the update section of our inner for loop. When you say j plus plus, now j value will become 3, right? Then after j value change to 3, it will go to the condition section. It will check j is lesser than 3 or not. No, j is not lesser than 3 now, because j value is 3, right? J is equal to 3. Condition is not satisfied here, so our inner for loop exit from here and it will come to the outer for loop and go to the update section of our outer for loop. What is the current I value here? Our current I value is a 0, right? When you go to update section, we are saying I plus plus. Now I value became 1. Then after I value became 1, it will come to the condition section checking I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, I is lesser than 3 because I current value is a 1, right? So it will come to the outer block coding part. Inside outer for loop coding part, here I am printing I current value. So it will print I equal to 1. Okay, after printing I equal to 1, again the inner for loop start executing. Whatever process I explained here, that same thing will repeat here. The same thing will repeat here. The same thing will repeat here. Okay. After printing j equal to 2, it will go to the update section. J will increase 3, right? Once j will increase 3, then it will check the condition. J is lesser than 3 or not. Here condition not satisfied because j current value is at 3, right? Condition not satisfied. So this since condition not satisfied, it will never come to inside a inner for loop block. It will exit from the inner for loop. It will go to again outer for loop update section. Outer for loop update section. What is the current value of I? Current value of I is a 1, right? So in the using update, I am changing the I value to 1. That meaning it will become I equal to 2. It will I equal to 2. After changing I equal to 2, it will check the condition now. I is lesser than or 3. I am checking. Yes, definitely I is lesser than 3 because I value is a 2 now. Condition satisfied. It will come to outer for loop coding part. It will print the current I value. Current I value is a, what is the current I value? Current I value is a 2. 2 will print. Current I value 2 will print. After printing 2, then this inner for loop again execute. This inner for loop again execute. The same process will happen again. The same process will happen again. It will print j equal to 0, j1, j2. It will print. Okay. After printing j2, then it will go to the update section. Update section of our inner for loop. It will increase the j value 1. That meaning j will become 3. Then check the condition. What is the j is lesser than 3 or not? No, j is not a lesser than 3. Currently j value is a 3. So it's not a lesser than 3. It's equal to 3. Condition not satisfied. So it will never come inside a inner for loop. It will go to outer for loop of update section. Outer for loop of update section. What is the current value of I now? Current value of I is 2, right? Using update section, I value get increased 1. That meaning I value increased 2 to 3. 2 to 3. After increasing 3, here again we are checking I lesser than 3 or not. No, I not lesser than 3 because I current value is a 3, right? So equal to 3. Condition not satisfied. So the control never come to here inside a for inside a outer for loop. Control never come to here. It exit from this for loop. It exit from this for loop. Okay. So output is like that. First time it will print I equal to 0, then it will print J0, J1, J2. Second time it will again print I equal to 1, then J0, J1, J2. Then third time it will print I equal to 2, then J0, J1, J2. Okay. According to this output, we understand that whenever we execute one time our outer for loop, our inner for loop completes its entire process, complete its entire execution. That is the concept of our nested for loop. Okay. Now I'll go to execute this program. The same thing I have written here. The same thing I have written here. Let's check the output now. Okay. Java C. Java nested for loop. See here I equal to 0. Here I am saying I equal to 0. Then J0, J1, J2. See here J0, J1, J2 is printed. Then after that again go to the outer for loop. I equal to 1. I equal to 1. J0, J1, J2. J0, J1, J2. Then I equal to 2. I equal to 2 here, then J0, J1, J2, here also J0, J1, J2. Okay. I hope you understand about the nested for loop. Okay, if you have any question, please ask question in the comment section. Definitely I will reply back to you. Then next is, you will going to learn about what is use of continuous statement and the break statement in the looping concept. In the looping concept, how to use break statement and the continuous statement in the looping concept. Okay. This is the example of break keyword. How to use break keyword in the for loop or while loop, do while loop. The same thing you can use for while loop as well as do while loop also. Okay. Here I am showing using for loop. Okay. this for loop execute three times, right? This for loop execute three times. According to this condition, this for loop execute three times. But here I am doing one check condition. If I equal to 0, that is whenever I value became 1, whenever I value became 1, I want to break this loop. I don't want to continue after that. Very first time, I value is a 0, right? 0 will print here. 0 will print here. It will come to inside a for loop, checking I equal to 1 or not. Very first time, I value 0, right? It's not equal to 1. 0 is not equal to 1. So, condition is not satisfied. It will never come here. Let me put braces also for better understanding. If it is single line, there is no braces. There no need to add braces. But for better understanding, I am adding a braces here. Okay. If I having a 1 value, I am saying that please break this program. Please break this for loop, I am saying. Very first time, I value 0, I am checking I equal to 1. Definitely not, because I value 0. It will never come inside this if block. It will come here, it will print 0. That is, it will print I equal to 0, right? Then it will go to update section. Using update section, I am increasing I value to 1. I++. When you say I++, it increases I value to 1. Okay, I value to 1. Then I am checking I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, I is lesser than 3 because I value is a 1. Now come to inside of for loop. Now I current value is a 1, right? I am checking I equal to 1. Yes, definitely I equal to 1 because currently I value is 1. Here condition is satisfied. Then break statement get executed. Break statement execute. Whenever you execute the break statement, what will happen? This entire for loop terminated and come outside from the for loop. Okay, that meaning according to this program, this will print only 0, nothing else, because we are breaking this for loop once I value reaches 1 here. Okay, let me check the output now. Java C break demo. See, only 0 is printing. Now I want to break this for loop whenever I value reaches 2. So if I value reaches 2, whenever I value became 2, I want to break this program. Let's see what's happening now. It will print I0, I1. Then it will come to update section. Increase the I value 1 to 2. Here condition will check I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, I is lesser than 3 because I current value is 2. Then inside a for loop, I am checking if I equal to, then I want to break this for loop. That is the reason 2 is not printing. 2 is not printing here. It's printing only 0 and 1. Okay, this is the concept of break. Now we are going to see what is the concept of continue. Let me save this program as a continue demo. Here now I am going to check 1. If I equal to 0, I want to say continue. What is the meaning of continue? What is the difference between continue and break keyword? Here I am checking if I value reaches 1, I am executing continue statement. Once we execute the continue statement, what will happen? After continue statement, whatever program we have returned, that program never execute. It will directly go to next execution of the for loop. Okay, next execution. Continue skips the current execution or iteration of the loop. This is the concept of continue. Each execution, right? So the for loop kind of cycle. Okay, each execution we can call it as an iteration. Okay, don't confuse why I'm using iteration. Iteration nothing but one execution of in your loop. Okay. So very first time I equal to 0, very first time I equal to 0, then it will come to, then it check the condition, I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, definitely I lesser than 3 because I value is a 0. I will come to inside the for loop. Now here I am checking if I equal to 1. No, very first time I is not a 1, it's a 0, right? It never execute this part, and it will come to print the current I value, print the current I value as a 0. Then it will go to again update section of the for loop. I value increase to 1, that is 0 to 1. Now I value, current value is a 0. Here we are checking the condition, I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, I lesser than 3 because I current value is a 1. Then it will come to inside a for loop. Inside a for loop, here I am checking I having a value 1 or not. Yes, currently I having a value 1. So it will come to inside a if block. It execute the continue statement. Once execute the continue statement, it will never execute this program. It never execute this program. Instead of that, it will go to next iteration. That means it will go to update section. It will go to update section, increase 1. That meaning current I value is 1, right? When you increase 1, meaning it will become 2. It will become 2. Then it will come to the condition section. I lesser than 3 or not. I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, current I value is a 2, right? It's a lesser than 3. Condition satisfied. And come here to check I equal to 1 or not. No, condition not satisfied because I is having a 2. It will never come here. It will come and print 2. I equal to 2 will print. So according to this output, we have skipped one iteration. If whenever I value became 1, I don't want to print that current I value. Whenever I equal to 1, I don't want to print the current I value. Instead of that, I want to continue. I want to continue meaning I want to process next iteration. I want to process next execution. So it will go to the update section, increase the I value and check the condition. If condition satisfied, it will come here. It will come here and print the statement. Okay. I am explaining again now. Very first time I value equal to 0, then it will check I lesser than 3 or not. Yes, I lesser than 3, condition satisfied. It will come to inside a for loop. Here I am checking if I equal to 1 or not. Currently I value is a not a 1, it's a 0, right? So it will never come here. And it will execute this statement. That meaning it will print I equal to 0. After printing that, it will go to update section of our for loop. In the update section, I am saying I plus plus. So it will increase I value to 1. Okay. If I value equal to 1, then I am saying execute the continue statement. If I value 1, I want to execute the continue statement. Now current I value is a 1, right? It will come to inside if block, execute the continue statement. Whenever execute the continue statement, what will happen? It will never come here. Whatever program we have written after continue, never execute. Instead of, it will go to the next iteration. It will go to the next iteration and update the current I value. What is the current I value? I value is 1, right? 1 to 2 it will go to increase. Then after increasing I value 1 to 2, here I am checking the condition I lesser than or 3. Yes, I lesser than 3 because I value is a 2. Condition satisfied and come to our if block. Here checking I equal to 1 or not. No, I is not a 1. Currently I value is a 2. This condition is not satisfied. So it never come inside if block. Then it will go to print this statement as a I equal to 2. That's it. This is the output. Okay. This is the use of continue statement. Using continue statement, if you want to skip one execution or one iteration from the loop, we can use continue keyword. Okay, let me check the output now. Java C. See, it's printing 0 and 2 only. 1 is not at all printing because I am skipping that one iteration here. I'm skipping that one iteration using continue statement. Whenever I become a 1, I want to continue. I want to continue to next iteration, next execution. I don't want to execute whatever statement we have written after continue, whenever I value became 1. Okay, that's the reason I value 1 is not printing here, Okay, I hope you understand what is the use of continue statement and what is the use of break statement. Okay, if you have any question, please ask question in the comment section. Definitely I will reply back. In the next Java session, we are going to talk about arrays, array variable. What is array variable? How to use for each loop using array variable? Those information we are going to explore in the next session. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.